Chapter 4, The Parent Lottery. The two people that help and inspire me most are my parents. Without them, I would not be here today, and words are not enough to express how thankful I am for them to be in my life. The thing I like about my parents is that they're okay with whatever my siblings and I want to be in life and will support it. Growing up, they have always loved and supported my ideas. They will give my siblings and I what we want as long as we take care of our business, such as school, future plans, and our well-being. They inspire me to be successful in life and to always strive for the best results, and will support me toward these goals. Other than my parents, the people that help inspire me are my two sisters, Vanessa and Jocelyn. They have always been there for me and are great sisters, and I love them so much. I am really thankful to have them in my life, and I don't think I would be the same person today without them. Also, my friends, especially Daniel and Darian. They are my day ones, and without them, I am not sure how my life would be. We all started skating in 8th grade and helped each other progress, and was one of the many bonds we built together since middle school. Daniel is a very good friend and can always give a good advice when I need it. He inspires me to do good in school, and I envy his 4.2 GPA. Darian inspires me to skate and work out, and he has come far with those two activities. He never fails to give good advice and is a very good friend. I have both known Daniel and Darian since 7th grade, and they have had a good impact on my life and are the real ones that always got my back. Chapter 7, I Never Made It to the NFL. Randy believes that our critics are the ones who really care about us the most. A person that really fits that description is my grandma. Growing up, my grandma would always take care of me while my parents were at work. And it was like that up until 15, when she decided to move back to the Philippines. She was so wise and loved me so much. I was her best friend, and she always taught me how to be good to myself and how to eat right. My grandma was probably my number one critic, always teaching me how to do things the right way, in her perspective. But she was only like this because she really cares about me and wants me to grow up right. She would always be teaching me how to do stuff in more natural ways because she believed going to the doctors was not good to get medication and only want the money. She was very old school, and I guess you could say she raised me right, but her impact on my life really did make me a better person. Another critic of mine was my dad. He can be hard on me and try to push myself to try my best. He always critiques my grades and how I perform when it comes to basketball. I know he was just like this because he wants me to be the best I can be and is doing it because he is a good dad. Chapter 24, A Recovering Jerk. Some of the feedback I have received in life, especially from friends and family, has changed my mentality and outlook on life. A crucial part of my life was freshman year for me. It was a very maturing part of my life and needed a lot of feedback and advice during that time. One of the best feedback I have ever heard was that nobody's opinions on you don't really matter, and you don't have to care about what others think about you all the time. If you like something or have a passion for it, then who cares what another person thinks of it? You just keep doing what you'd like to do. Other feedback that has helped me in life has been through skating. My friends' feedback on how I perform the tricks has made me a better skateboarder, and I wouldn't be the same skateboarder without their feedbacks today. I started skating in 8th grade with my friends and had so much fun making so many memories. I started to love when I would learn new tricks and see how far I've come since I started. Chapter 28, Dream Big. There hasn't been a time where I recall an adult crushing my dreams because they haven't been that straightforward to me. But if a kid has a dream, you shouldn't bring them down with doubt because that doesn't do anything good. Instead, you can support them and have them show you they can do it and will work for it with hard work and determination. Even if you think the kid can't accomplish that dream, you at least give them positivity instead of bringing them down with negativity, because you never know, they might actually make that dream a reality. So if you ever hear about a kid's dream, believe in them and tell them to keep pushing towards it rather than crush it and give them an ugly truth on what you think will happen. Chapter 53, Never Give Up. At the start of freshman year was online school, and they gave us loads of work to do online. This eventually led me to start failing most of my classes, which also led to me being unmotivated to catch up with all the missing assignments I had. At that point, I realized I hit a brick wall and didn't know what to do to overcome it. Until the second semester came, which also came with a fresh start of all my classes, which finally motivated me and gave me the chance to bring it back up. I then stayed on top of everything and didn't fall behind the whole semester and finished strong at the end of the year with straight A's. I didn't give up and finally overcame that brick wall once the second semester started and showed that you should always keep trying even if you fail. I am glad that this happened though. Although I felt like I was at a low point in my life and felt like I was disappointing everyone, it has taught me that you can't keep dwelling and being stuck on the past. You just need to accept that it happened and to keep moving forward for yourself. The loved ones in my life, like my mom, my dad, my sisters, my friends, have all shaped me into the person I am today and can't thank them enough. I love you guys.